Around the end of last year, we finally got a port of Halo's Master Chief Collection for PC. And in a shocking turn of events, it's actually pretty good. And I haven't seen my family for about 3 months. But the most important part of it is that it actually has new content, something never before seen in a video game port until now. And I'm here to talk about it. I think I'm the first guy to do that, actually. But first, I just want to point out that I am completely new to Halo Online. I just refuse to pay for a glitchy-ass, painful service that's free on PC.
So yeah, you're gay.
So this is all coming from a guy who's never played the Xbox version of any of the game's online modes. Also, I'm not going to be mentioning the campaigns a whole lot, because every single degenerate on this website has already talked about them. And you can switch between the original Combat Evolved and Anniversary graphics, so that's pretty much the only thing I care about. Something they finally did add in the PC port, however, are custom games. Custom games are custom matches created by players, which let them create their own game mode based off Halo Reach's original multiplayer modes with varying degrees of quality, which any player can join, and they go a bit like this. At the beginning of each custom game round, you'll need to choose between one of 5 armor abilities. The first one being Armor Lock, which generates an almost impenetrable shield around the player for almost 6 seconds, which deflects tank missiles, grenades, snipes, normal bullets, RPGs, and can even blow up boosting vehicles. And if that wasn't enough, once the shield ends, it sends out a shockwave in all directions from the player, which shoots any enemy grenades out of harm's way, something Inside would shamelessly steal 2 years later. Naturally, the ability's sheer power to make anyone want to
game in
themselves after being killed because of it has caused a bit of an outrage in the Halo community. On one hand, I have to respect 343 for actually having a spine and not immediately nerfing it, but on the other hand, I absolutely f***ing hate it. Next up is the jetpack, also known as the best one if you want to avoid being called racial slurs in chat. God rest its soul. The only trade-off is that it creates a lot of noise, alerting every single Adderall-fueled 9-year-old within a 5-mile radius to your location. It's a pretty good ability if you prefer mobility over defense, but the game's weird moon physics, which make falling and dodging slow to a crawl while in the air, are pretty hard to get your head around at first. The hologram ability creates a duplicate of yourself who runs towards a set location before imploding, something Apex Legends would shamelessly steal 5 years later. This can be used to trick enemies into thinking you're somewhere when you're actually somewhere else, you know, if the pathfinding doesn't have a stroke. Active camo, amazingly, gives the player an active camouflage painfully similar to the one from Combat Evolved. And as such, it covers the player in some sort of Premiere Pro Gaussian blur effect, which almost makes you stand out more against the foliage if you're trying to hide from a sniper. However, much like the hologram, it works wonders against the mentally disabled. The drop shield creates an energy shield that regenerates your health, which survives until shot out enough, and the rest are pretty self-explanatory. And now onto the actual games. They're pretty good. For the most part. They're not too different from the normal Reach multiplayer matches, depending on which variant you choose, and as long as you don't live in Australia, you'll be fine. I think the biggest problem with them is that they're the only games anyone ever uses now, so trying to join a regular multiplayer server will take about 5 hours to get enough players together to actually start the match, and they'll all probably be children anyway. Also, there's no skill-based matchmaking like in Apex Legends or any other shooter, so you could be the most retarded, mentally impaired, terrible player ever, and be matched against a 25-year-old Redditor with 100% achievement progress. There's also seasons with unlockable items that you can work your way through by playing matches. These rewards include cosmetics that have no competitive advantage. Yeah, I know it's almost identical to Fortnite, but like, it's an MMO in 2021, what did you expect? So yeah, Halo's a pretty good game, but most importantly, you can set your spotting code to the funny weed number. 10 out of 10. Thank you all for watching, follow my Twitter if you want. I apologize for the relatively short video, especially after such a long wait, but I've been beginning to focus more on my channel, so expect longer and higher quality videos soon. I know I've said that at the end of like 5 of my videos at this point, but shut up.